Kara with the Bag Builder, and I'm going to show you very quickly how to get burgers from a bag to a pan without ever having touched raw meat. So I've got my ground beef in here. You saw a video of me transferring it in bulk, and that's why I use the bag holder, because I never have to worry about touching it, or I never have to worry about getting raw meat at the edge. Now I'm going to add my little bit of seasoning, just seasoning, salt. You can add pretty much whatever you want. We're plain Jane kind of folks here, so we're going to just do it. Just a little salt. Then I'm going to put it on a pan and cook it in butter, because I love butter burgers. And then I'll add onions, and you know my husband doesn't do that. So I've got the bag holder, and now I'm going to mix all of these seasonings up in here very nicely so that it's blended well. And see, I can mash and mix and knead so much better with my hands than doing any mixer or having to do this. And my hands are clean. I don't have to worry about getting the phone or if my kids have an injury. My hands are never dirty. My counters are never dirty. I don't stress about the germs. So I've got the meat is mixed completely, and I'm going to form it. And this is how I do it. And maybe we can get a close-up just on the ground beef here. You see me forming it into a pan, or a flat, forming it flat into the bag. Do you see that? And this is, again, about a pound of meat. So I really need to get about four burgers. So I'm just forming it right out. You see this? I'm going to form it so it looks good to me to fit about four burgers. And the beauty is I'm forming it all here. So you can do this with Salisbury steak, mini meatloaves, big meatloaf, burgers, etc. So I've got it. Now I'm going to cut it. And like I said, whenever I use raw meat, unfortunately I do not wash and reuse those bags. It's just simpler to me to just throw away. So we're cutting this bag. And I'm not having to touch it at all. I just grab from the outside. I'm going to put these scissors here because they're going to be washed. And I will open this side. Now, what I'm going to do is I've got my spatula. It's the only thing that really is going to get dirty besides the scissors. And I'm going to cut it right down the center. And then I'm going to cut it down the center again. Basically crisscross, applesauce, or burgers. And I'm putting these burgers right on a pan, just like that. Look at that. Easy, easy. Do you see how easy this is? And again, I'm not touching it. And when I cook it, it doesn't look any different being square or round. It could care less. It tastes the same in my belly. It's another great way that you can freeze it this way, too, if you wanted to the burgers and you wanted to have season them beforehand. But, guys, that is my burger showing talent of making burgers and never having to touch raw meat again. So, guys, don't be left holding the bag.